Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to review for you a non-beauty product. Ta-ding! Okay, I recently got the Samsung Galaxy Note S3 as a birthday gift from Duncan. This is what the phone looks like. It's massive. It's as big as my head almost. And I don't care. This one I really like the new feel of the back, because it feels like faux leather with very nice stitching here. I'm not gonna go into technical stuff because I'm not a techie. I've had my other Samsung phone, the Samsung S2, for over 2 years, and I've loved that phone. In fact, it still works pretty well. The only reason that I wanted to upgrade, even though there came an S3 4 and S4, and soon there's gonna be an S5, but I wanted the Galaxy Note 3 because of the S Pen. You see how that came out? The moment you pull this out, that's gonna come out, and it's giving you the command for action memo. That's the first one. You've got a scrapbooker, you've got screen write, you've got S Finder, and you've got pen window. I just opened the S Note application and I can actually write on there. I don't know if you can see that. It's not reflecting, yeah? Doodle, doodle. You can even increase the size of your pen. So you can see this. I'm going to increase that. Okay. La-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da. You can doodle on there. I'm going to go ahead and erase everything now. Okay, and it's back off. But that's not the only reason why I got it.
Message from Stitch. Shall I read it?
Oh, there goes my phone telling me. Yes, go ahead, read it.
Which one?
The one from
Stitch. How about a specific instruction like, call Shellagun Gun HD, call Mitch T, call Melvin.
No. Meg Select Bernardo. Manually.
Please choose manually and I will learn it.
See, that's my assistant from this phone. It's very, very good. I can tell it to do whatever I like it to do. It's pretty cool, actually. I got a message, that's what it's telling me, and it's a happy birthday message from one of our staff. So let's go ahead and say thank you. The great thing about this as well is that I can just swipe and it will write what I want. Nice, huh? I think it's awesome. But the best part of this, and the main reason why I got this, is because I wanted to start vlogging and I wanted a camera that works really, really well in terms of blogging. Now, my problem with a lot of the point-and-shoot cameras is that not a lot of them have like a flip-out screen. I do have one, the Samsung MV800 has a flip-out screen, but the quality is only up to 720p, which is not full HD, right? So I wanted to get a camera that would be able to record in full HD, and this little baby here can record in full HD now. And whether you're using the back facing camera or the front facing camera, it's really good. So to give you an idea of how good it is, I'm actually going to record a few bits of this video to get with this camera that I'm using, which is my Canon one, and this, and I'll put in the clip, okay, into the video so you can actually see what I'm doing and how good this video, the video of this camera is. And it's really nice. I'm gonna have to tell you, it's really nice. It records in full HD, 1920x1080p, and it's got 2.3 gigahertz in terms of CPU speed. What else do I have to say, right? It's really quick. It's got 3 GB RAM for in terms of memory, but it's got a 32 GB memory internally, and you can expand it to another 32 or even 64. It depends on what kind of SD card you have. The battery life is really good. It's 3,200 milliamperes of battery, What else does it say here? It's got GPS, stylus pen, which you've already seen. The back camera is 13 megapixels, while the front camera is 2 megapixels. But the quality of the front camera is nothing like my Samsung S2. Like, it's not grainy, it's not noisy with the right lighting. It's perfect. I love it. I love it. Okay. So, do I recommend this product? I do, absolutely. I love Android products. I used to be a big fan of the iPhone ones. I used to be a big fan of iOS, but for some reason, I find that these are easier to use. And yeah, that's it. If you want an in-depth review of this little baby here, I suggest you do a YouTube search, because there's a lot that's out there. I'm not a very techie person, so I can only tell you as much as how I use it. But as you can tell, I already have like 4 pages full of applications on there. What are my favorite applications there? Of course, there's Twitter, there's Facebook, there's Instagram, there's Pinterest. In terms of making a collage for Instagram, I use InstaFrame. I've also got the Pencil Sketch and Color Splash, Pixel Express. I also have a few games in here. I've got Audible on here as well. Then I have YouTube on here. I've got WhatsApp. I've got Viber. I've got Duolingo if you want to learn another language. I'm trying to learn French. I've got TuneIn Radio if you want to listen to the radio stations back in your home if you're not in your home. I've got Moves, which tracks your activities on the days to see if you're burning calories. I've got Noom Coach, which is also a health one. And Samsung also has a few apps of its own that's installed in here, which like I've got here, Walking Mate, and it tracks how many steps I make during the day. And my goal is to do 10,000 steps, which is a lot, but yeah, it's a good goal, right? Yeah, I've got massive ones, and I've also got BBM on here. Yeah, it's very, very handy. I love this. I recommend it. Highly recommend it.